So we just saw in the last presentation a 24-layer 3D scanner, which algorithms are the base for autonomous ships. But not limited to this, the same scanner can be used for totally different applications. And a very impressive example for this is the Man Overboard system. And therefore, we welcome Sandra. Hinrich, what will we see?
Right, in the next presentation from Sandra, we will see that scanners are used to detect objects falling from board. And by using artificial intelligence algorithms, we can distinguish if it's between objects and people. And Sandra Wienberg from Hamburg will take us now on a journey, starting with the idea, why is the development to a final product installed on board a ship? And we will have an interview with our Norway partner, Insta, with Perry Stave. Sandra, what was the motivation for you to develop a man overboard system?
The motivation was to increase the security on boards in the maritime industry, actually.
Okay, great. So now we are curious on your next 15 minutes. Please, stage is yours.
Thank you, Ramona. Thank you, Hinrich. And welcome to my discourse about man overboard. I'm sure many of you have heard about people have gone missing on cruise ships, but maybe some of you haven't realized that we talk about up to 60 people who disappear every year on their journey while traveling or working on ships. The root cause is that the loss is not detected in an appropriate time to initiate the rescue operation. Due to the sea drift and the speed of the boat, it is quite difficult to define the exact location of the person who has gone offboard. The current prescribed maneuver in a man overboard situation is to release a dinghy to rescue. But still, time and assumed place are the critical factors. The highest chances of survival is a complete rescue within 30 minutes. Imagine stopping and turning around a cruise ship. This will not only take a lot of time, it also gonna cost up to $500,000. And a false alarm can jeopardize the complete time schedule as well. The man overboard system intends to trigger the alarm in real time and forward this information to the rescue team so they can start the rescue operation immediately. In the next video, I can show you a typical situation and as well how this process is gonna start. This could be a typical situation on board. Even in such large numbers of people, sometimes it is not noticeable if a person falls overboard.
Let me show you the video from our partner INSA. The highlighted green area around the ship marks a detection area of the scanners. Ideally, this protection area is completely covered by the system around the ship. When a member of the crew or a passenger falls off of the ship into the water, he or she is in need of immediate rescue. The LiDAR detects the issue immediately and triggers the alarm in real time. The system does not only trigger the alarm, but it also reports time and place within the monitored area. The computer calculates then the estimated position of the person in distress by taking the information from the scanner, the GPS position, the speed of the ship, and even the tidal current. This estimated position can be approached within several minutes by a dinghy, or even faster with a drone, as you can see in this video. Our partner INSA from Norway has developed such a system that sends a drone in case of emergency. This drone locates the person that has gone overboard within several minutes and provides a self-inflated life preserver until a dinghy arrives. To avoid human delays and misunderstandings that waste precious time in a rescue operation, this system operates autonomically. Therefore, it's one of our goals to reduce the false alarms to a minimum.
After watching this video, it seems quite obvious why we think it is essential to have a man overboard system on every boat or vessel. But still, I want to share with you further benefits. Besides increasing the security on ships by providing the relevant information to the rescue team, it also reduces overall costs, effort of reporting after an incident, and even insurance issues. By providing high reliability, it also avoids error-related costs, turnaround time, and downtime. And let us be honest, it also improves the reputation of the cruise providers. The Man Overboard system is a complex solution from SIG, and we have already invested into research, development, and qualification. With the next video, I want to take you to some of the steps during the formation.
At the beginning, we were evaluating which of our 3D sensors is the best fit for our requirements. We have qualified different SIG scanners, but as mentioned at the beginning of my presentation, the benefit of the Emerus 6000 is that it is providing us with 24 gapless layers. The scan view on the left-hand side shows the rectangular scan point based on a remission value that visualizes the gapless point cloud that looks almost like a grayscale video. Isn't it impressive? But is it also able to capture an object within several seconds? This is why we have started to throw different items from our window at the office. Boxes in different sizes and even our first provisional dummy. We have seen good first results and the potential to a solution. We have also tested that in a more realistic environment during day and nighttime. In the second phase, we were able to carry out prepared tests in the swimming pool in Denzlingen, close to Freiburg, Germany. 9 water-loving colleagues jumped from the 10, 5 and a 3-meter tower and provided the technical team with data. Different heights, jumps and shapes were added to the database. This enabled us to optimize the algorithm further. The particular difficulty of this application is the speed of fall of the object. In a fraction of a second, it falls through the measuring planes of the sensor and has to be identified within this time. At the same time, the sensor has to mask out waves, foam and other irrelevant objects. On the other side, a lot of data is not always beneficial when it comes to process data in real time. With the background removal feature, we filter out the irrelevant background information and focus only on object data. With all the new insights and software, we were able to enter the qualification phase. The green box you can see in the video represents the region of interest we are looking at. The yellow scan points are showing the buildings around. Again, we can see the items falling from the top into the region of interest. The vector you can see on screen visualizes the trajectory, which is basically based on the speed and the direction of the falling object. We collected more data and it took us some time to identify persons from other items. The first customer appointments have been already scheduled and we were pleased to show them our results. We demonstrated the functionality and our visitors were impressed by the high detection probability. Due to the gapless scan, we have enough detected scan points on the body. Together with the direction and the size, this object is identified as a person and activates the trigger. In the same time, we have started to qualify the special protection housing in the rain chamber at our headquarters in Waldkirch. This rain chamber, with a total length of 18.5 meter, measured on various distances to the dummy and simulated different water densities that varies between heavy spray water and low tropical rain. We can proudly say that after over 15 hours of heavy rain, the device stayed dry on the inside and detected the dummy reliably. So it was time for an endurance test with the Man Overboard system under real conditions. Together with our partner INSA, we were able to take the prototype for a test drive on a vessel in the Nordic Sea. We have been very excited to capture real-time data and see our LiDAR perform as expected. Even after several months, the device didn't require any maintenance. We also came back to take the first steps into the verification of the device according to the DNVGL class guideline for environmental test specification for electrical, electronic and programmable equipment and system in the maritime industry. For the trials, we have prepared another pair of full-size mannequins, deck chairs and a large bird dummy on a fishing rod that we have used to prove to an independent surveyor that the Man Overboard system detects reliably. Different drop heights and distances to the sensor have been tested. our partner INSA took as well the opportunity to bring their drone into action. The self-inflated life preserver were attached to the sides of the drone and made successfully their way to the emergency location. Please meet INSA.
Thank you very much for your time, Peristava. As the CEO of the INSA SA that offers ship companies a safety check of their ships to uncover possible dangers and incidents, you have seen a great need for a rescue system for men overboard. As I have already shown to our spectators, the system requires a reliable 3D LiDAR sensor to trigger an alarm and the rescue measure. 2019, you have contacted SIX for collaboration. How did the partnership come about and why did you choose SIC?
When INSA doing operation in different cruise vessels, we discovered that there was no system for detecting a man overboard. Due to the high number of drowning, we decided to solve this problem. INSA started to develop the first autonomic man overboard system. This by using drone and also advanced sensor technology. To obtain high reliability for the sensor part, we actually searched the market for the best sensor available. Here we find the MRS-6000 very interesting. A contact with SIC was established and a mutual development contract was signed. We then together developed the sensor software to eliminate all false alarms. And as we know, losing lives is a huge cost for the company and a tragedy for the involved family. To have our system installed on a vessel, the shipping company will strengthen their reputation and avoid losing life to man overboard.
Yeah, man has been going overboard since there have been ships. What is your experience with the current technologies for man overboard application?
INSA have a very high knowledge in this area. We have experience from maritime, military, oil and gas, police, and law enforcement and tactics. This together give us a great knowledge to the problem with a man overboard. We also have studied some other system on the market, but we did not find those good enough. To support this statement, INSA also working in the cruise industry with safety and security matters.
INSA is already approaching customers with the available technology. Are there any other projects in the area of man overboard, and how do you see this technological trend?
Well, INSA have also other projects under development that will be added to the ProEye in the nearest future. This is related to security, surveillance, docking, many more. By using technology like MRS-6000 sensor, we can use it in many different tasks. And up to this point, no other system has reached this level of performance. And therefore, INSA is quite sure this is the way to go.
The system is now almost in a final stage. What are your plans?
Well, together with SIC, INSA have a plan to become a major supplier for the man overboard detection and rescue system. Our system had so many advantages and innovative solution that we think this would be the preferred system for saving life at sea.
I appreciate the time you took to speak with us about INSA and also the man overboard market. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
If we think of man overboard, we also might think of security on other ships or other places around the harbor. The reliable detection of falling objects also enables us to be more than that I have shown you. So with slight adaption, this principle could be used also on on houseboats, yachts, bridges, or even to secure oil rigs. We're definitely seeing the importance of this application for now and the future. And We hope to be a part of this journey to a safer place in the maritime industry. Before we'll answer your questions, I want to show you some further impressions from our test drive in Norway. I hope you have enjoyed the discourse about Men Overboard, and I want to invite you for further discussions on how we can support you. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Sandra, for this great presentation. It looked like a lot of fun testing the system in the summertime in the pool, so I hope you enjoyed also the whole development of this process. We already have some questions in the chat, which I will ask you now. So, first of all, can this man overboard system be used for FPSOs or drill rigs as well?
Yes, well, right now, as it is, we need to adapt the system, of course, because of the different heights that are used in different applications. But it is the same principle, so we think while developing further and further, we can also look into other applications.
Okay, thank you. Another question is, the system able to determine if a person is working in the venue or a guest is working there?
Again, please, I haven't got that.
Is the system able to determine if a person is working in the venue or a guest?
I think such kind of applications we also have to test.
So maybe a last question. Are there any technological solutions for man overboard detection based on underwater acoustics or any similar?
Currently, we also, as Robert mentioned, we measure above the sea level. So I think there are no other technologies that can detect under sea level.